Welcome, Your Honor. It is a pleasure to have you with us this evening. We also extend a warm welcome to a number of elected officials with us tonight, representing the federal, provincial, and municipal governments, in addition to a number of Catholic School Board trustees and partners in education from the Toronto Catholic District School Board. We welcome the many family members from the St. Michael's Choir School community and all those who are joining us from across the Greater Toronto area for this very special evening. 5 years ago, we embarked on a rigorous plan to restore St. Michael's Cathedral from the basement crypts entombing our first bishop, Michael Power, and the other prominent families of early Toronto in 1867. This neo-Gothic structure has been a spiritual, historical, and cultural icon for the City of Toronto for the last 168 years. It is a designated heritage property, and its importance has also been recently recognized by the Vatican's Congregation for Divine Worship and the Discipline of the Sacraments, who have granted us the status of a minor basilica. St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica is the spiritual home for a living, vibrant, and socially alive community. One of the most vibrant parts of that community is the world-renowned St. Michael's Choir School. Known for its choral and academic excellence, many of the alumnus of the choir school have gone on to be leaders in industry, politics, as well as conductors, choral masters, members of choirs, and opera singers locally, nationally, and globally. St. Michael's Choir School provides the music for our services here at the Cathedral Basilica, and they also tour regularly throughout Canada and around the world. But even with the excellence of the choir school, something had been missing from our cathedral since 1994. Something so very important, it is called the heart of liturgical worship. Thanks to the expertise of one of the best known and most respected pipe organ builders in the world, the heart of our cathedral has been restored. The new Cassavant organ, Opus 3907, installed in our restored balcony, has been described by Jacqueline Rochette, artistic director of Cassavant, as one of the finest instruments they have built, and I believe the best in the City of Toronto. As rector of the cathedral and of the choir school, I am honored to host this evening of sacred music in celebration of the renewal of St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica. It has been a difficult and challenging journey to this night, with many obstacles and unforeseen circumstances along the way. The journey that would not have been possible without the construction workers and artists who have worked tirelessly on its restoration. These talented men and women have taken great care in the work of restoring the Mother Church of the Archdiocese to its original beauty, recognizing that it will be witness to all that enter through its doors for generations to come. Last but not least, none of this would have been possible without the guidance and support of our Archbishop, His Eminence, Thomas Cardinal Collins. So before we begin our concert, I would like to call on His Eminence to say a few words. So please help me welcome Cardinal Collins.
These last few days have been truly magnificent. As last night we consecrated this glorious cathedral once more for the glory of God and for the service of our whole community. This is holy ground. This is the place where from 1848 people have worshiped. And as here we have the tomb of our heroic first bishop directly under the high altar, Michael Power, who showed us an example of prayer and devotion which led to the creation of this cathedral, and of sacrificial love which he showed to the refugees who came to our community, the little town of Toronto in 1847, when 40,000 refugees came to a town of 20,000 people. And along with people of many faiths, he went to help them, to care for them, And indeed, on October the 1st, 1847, he died at the age of 43 from the typhus that he had contracted in the service of those who were most in need. That spirit of generous, sacrificial love is what guides us to this day, all of us in this whole community, of which his cathedral is indeed a very center and high point. And so it's so important that this cathedral be what he had wanted it to be, a place where we worship the Lord God and then are sent out in the service, practical, humble service, as he did at the fever sheds down by the waterfront in those days many years ago, service of those who are in need. It's that welcoming community, which is, I think, the model for us all as we follow in the footsteps of Michael Power and in the example of Christian discipleship. I'm deeply grateful to Father Bush and for the whole team, renovation team, that made this glorious cathedral. It is just spectacular, and here we see beauty. And the great transcendental values are beauty, truth, and goodness. And as people come in here and are touched by the beauty, we hope and pray they may come to a deeper appreciation of the truth that guides us and be through that transformed into people who live a life of goodness, of charity, which is the power that moves the sun and all the stars. And that is what this cathedral is for. So I welcome all of you gathered together, Your Honor, and all of our dear friends and guests to come here for this experience this evening and to come many, many times. This is, the doors are open to one and all. And today especially, to listen to the magnificent beauty, not only visual as we see around us, but the beauty of music. In 1937, Monsignor Ronan founded the St. Michael's Cathedral Choir School. And it has, over the years, it is world famous, it is legendary, the excellence of music. St. Augustine said in the motto of the choir school, that's taken as its motto, the one who sings prays twice. And so we'll be doing a lot of praying tonight, which is appropriate in a cathedral, as we listen to the magnificent music of the St. Michael's Choir School, that great treasure which is so closely linked to this magnificent cathedral. So welcome to one and all as we enjoy this evening together.
Thank you, Your Eminence. At select intervals in our program, we will have the opportunity to hear some brief remarks from some of the other dignitaries with us tonight. Thank you again for coming tonight. I wish you a most pleasant evening, and know, as the Cardinal has said, that you are always welcome here at St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica. I now ask you to join me in welcoming our MC for this evening, Mr. Stephen Handergan, the director of St. Michael's Choir School.
Thank you, Father Bush. It is wonderful to be with you all tonight on such an historic occasion. For almost 80 years, St. Michael's Choir School has served as an important element in the mission of St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica. The mission of the school and the vision of our founder, Monsignor John Edward Ronan, is as vital today as it was on the first day of school in 1937, when 18 boys gathered in a single classroom in the diocesan office building next door at 67 Bond Street. The school has grown significantly since 1937, and tonight, all 275 choir boys will raise their voices in song in this magnificent cathedral basilica. What a blessing. Our concert begins with Flor Peter's Entrata Festiva, Opus 93, a piece that features our magnificent new cassavant organ, Opus 3907, and our special musical guests, True North Brass.
Thank you.
As Father Bush mentioned earlier, we have a number of special guests that are present with us tonight. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming to the podium the Lieutenant Governor of Ontario, the Honourable Elizabeth Dowdeswell.
Good evening, Cardinal Collins, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, bonsoir, bonjour. It's my very great pleasure to join you in this joyous celebration. Such music must surely eclipse any words I could speak this evening. As we come together today in celebrating all that St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica has meant to our community over the years, I want to acknowledge first this land as a traditional gathering place for the many Indigenous peoples of Turtle Island. I recognize the long history of First Nations and Métis people in Ontario and show respect in particular to the Mississaugas of the New Credit and the Anishinaabe people. The rededication of a cathedral is among the great liturgical services in the Catholic faith. To the church leaders, generous supporters, committed parishioners, highly skilled tradespeople, and all those of you who have contributed to the restoration of St. Michael's Cathedral, thank you for taking on such a great responsibility. In most cathedrals, one must read and wonder about the lives and character of those who created its works many generations ago. However, in this restoration, people of such dedication, skill, and devotion are walking among us. Please allow me to express my gratitude to you as we marvel at this newly restored historical treasure. To enter this cathedral is to feel a deep sense of connection to community, humanity, and to the higher purpose that faith inspires. This is a place of reverence where one speaks a little more softly and considers one's place in the world a little more fervently. It speaks to the broader value of places of worship. A cathedral reminds us that we are part of a continuum of humanity. These high walls and beautiful ceilings are a physical manifestation of the understanding that we must think beyond our own lives and work towards something much larger than ourselves. This was true from the earliest beginnings of St. Michael's. As we just heard, in 1847, Bishop Power traveled throughout Europe to recruit priests for this diocese, to raise funds for the building of this cathedral. He saw the depression and human tragedy unfolding during the Great Famine in Ireland. He wrote home to Toronto and urged local congregations to be prepared for the influx of people affected by the famine. In this way, St. Michael's was already rallying people to worthy causes from its very beginning, and you have continued to do so in all the years since. The people of St. Michael's continue to make a valued contribution to this city, our province, and our nation. And you give me hope that as a society seeks to address the challenges brought by an increasingly complex and interconnected world. I thank all the clergy and parishioners at St. Michael's for making this event a true community celebration. Your welcoming nature speaks to the lasting value that this beautiful cathedral contributes to the community. And thank you also to all of the members of the St. Michael's Choir School, a true cultural treasure for all in Ontario, for filling our hearts with the pure joy of music. I know that the character, discipline, confidence, and just a little bit of mischief that we see in these young people today will go on serving our province for many years to come. As Her Majesty the Queen's representative in Ontario, I congratulate and thank you most warmly as you renew the mission of this cathedral as a source of inspiration and force for good. I wish you a blessed 200th anniversary celebration. Thank you. Merci, Miigwech.
Thank you, Your Honor. We are also so grateful that you took the time out of your busy schedule to join us this special evening. We are also most fortunate to have with us this evening the Mayor of the City of Toronto to bring greetings on behalf of the city. Please join me in welcoming His Worship, Mayor John Tory.
Well, Your Honor, Your Eminence, Minister, and distinguished guests, one and all. I am particularly pleased and privileged to be here tonight as the Mayor of Toronto to attend this event as part of the events marking the beautiful renewal and, of course, the rededication of St. Michael's Cathedral. This is one of the most beautiful and most important and historic buildings in our city. And before I pass off the subject of beauty, I should say the beauty of the music we heard from those talented young men was quite remarkable, and I want to say to them congratulations and extend congratulations as well to parents and teachers who I'm sure had a lot to do with that as well. But you know, this is a building that is about the heart of our city, I think, in three respects. First, it is, and has been for a long time, when the city was much smaller, geographically located in the heart of the city. A very special place, which itself is being dramatically reborn, but which is also still home to some of our most vulnerable citizens. Second, it is one of the spiritual hearts of the city, a place so important for worship and sacred celebration that it has been designated as a basilica. And third, St. Michael's is, as it has always been, a part of the heart of this city when it comes to caring and comfort and compassion. It is home to our Roman Catholic community, which in so many ways and at so many times has come to the help and to the aid and to the comfort of so many people in so many different ways. Indeed, tonight is a night for me as the elected leader of our entire city, and I am very pleased to be joined here by the Deputy Mayor, Denzel Menon-Wong, by Councillor Justin DiCiano, and by Councillor Paul Ainslie. But it is my pleasure to take this opportunity to say thank you to this community, from the Cardinal all the way through to every single member, for all that you contribute. You as a community have made a singular contribution to the success that has brought us respect and admiration throughout the world for the way we live together. And I think that contribution will go forward from this building and throughout the city for many years to come. It's no accident that we are one of the most livable cities in the entire world, and you have helped to make that happen. And finally, may I say to His Eminence, to the clergy, to the leaders and the donors and the artisans and the skilled craftsmen and craftswomen who made this possible, thank you for your skill and dedication, and thank you for giving new life to a crucially important heritage building in a modern, dynamic city that we all love. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Tory. We are grateful you are able to be with us. I would also like to acknowledge the presence of a number of city councillors, including Deputy Mayor Denzel Menon-Wong, who attends St. Michael's Cathedral. I'd invite all the city councillors present to please stand and be recognized. We very much appreciate your support and thank you for all that you do. The young men now entering the cathedral are the grade threes and fours of St. Michael's Choir School. These boys have been working so hard this past month to prepare for their first ever concert here in the Cathedral Basilica. For all of our grade 3 class and several of our grade 4s, this is also their first ever concert with the choir school. Please join me in welcoming the elementary choir.
Thank you.
The graduates of St. Michael's Choir School go on to remarkable careers in so many fields and are leaders in their communities. Some, like our next speaker, go into political life. To bring greetings from the federal government of Canada, please join me in welcoming Member of Parliament for Eglinton Lawrence, Mr. Marco Mendocino.
Well, Gloria in excelsis Deo indeed. Well done, boys. Well done. Your Eminence, Your Excellencies, Your Worship, elected dignitaries, faculty of St. Michael's, distinguished guests. I am deeply honored to have been invited to attend tonight's celebration of the rededication of this holy ground here at St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica. A wave of memory and nostalgia poured over me as I entered through the doors and saw the choir and made my way through the procession. For as some of you may know, I spent a good part of my childhood in this place as a student at the choir school. And I can assure you, Your Excellency, that there was indeed a small measure of mischief in all of us. Even now, I can look over to the sanctuary and recall my favorite seating assignment when I was in the choir. It was actually at the rightmost end of the pew where I could look out into the congregation and watch as they celebrated Mass and absorbed the reverberations of Palestrina, of Bach, and Durafle. I recall vividly singing here on Sundays, over all the high holidays, and on special occasions like the papal visit in 1984. And as a young chorister, I remember being completely overcome with emotion when Pope John Paul II made the sign of the cross and he bestowed his blessings on all of us. Being here tonight makes it seem just like yesterday. I remember Miss Mann, I remember Mr. Ray, and of course, very fondly, Father Armstrong, and I am confident that they are looking down on us right now, filled with pride, and perhaps wondering, how did Marco get here? I'm sure some of my classmates and my teachers are wondering the same thing. An act of God. But the hard work, the discipline, and the faith they instilled in me are without question the pillars of my public service. The foundation of this Archdiocese of Toronto is very much rooted in devotion to God, which reveals itself in so many ways through devotion to one another. Michael Power, the first Bishop of St. Michael's, was dedicated to helping settle Irish refugees as they landed here in Toronto on the new shores in the 1830s and 40s. Bishop Power did not survive to see the full construction of this cathedral, but his work lives on now in the ministry of Cardinal Collins, who, like his forefathers, continues the work of spreading the liturgy to this community, and yes, as well, to new refugees and new Canadians. Bishop Power would indeed be in awe of His Eminence's work, those of this clergy, the volunteers, the choir, and yes, through their voice, we all do sing twice and pray twice. He would also be in awe of this magnificent restoration. The tower, the ceilings, the attention to detail, the organ, I wish I could play it. It truly has transformed this church to its original beauty, and in doing so, has given us a place of serenity, of reflection, and holiness. In life, as time passes on, we become more and more preoccupied with the hustle and bustle of our everyday routines. Work, school, raising the kids, the chores. Life can be hard. I can assure you of that as a young father with the responsibility of representing a constituency. I'm sure you can all relate to it. And it is indeed very easy to lose sight of that which is most important to us. Those who are closest to us, our sense of faith.
our faith indeed can be put to the test. So for those of you who understand and relate to that, let us take up Cardinal Collins on his invitation to come to this holy ground, to come here to pray, to reflect, to do good service to one another. Let us celebrate this restoration and in so doing restore our own faith. Congratulations to you, Your Eminence, to the alumni, to all of the contributors, to all of the wonderful people who helped restore this wonderful cathedral to its original beauty. Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here, Mr. Mendocino. It is so wonderful to see a choir school alumnus making important contributions to our country. We also very much appreciate the ongoing support of the province of Ontario. To bring greetings on behalf of the Premier, please welcome the Minister of Finance, the Honourable Charles Souza.
Good evening, Your Eminence, Your Honor, Your Worship, special guests. It's a great honor for me to be here with all of you this evening. But I'd like to begin by thanking the outstanding students of St. Michael's Choir. Thank you to those wonderful boys for sharing their beautiful music with all of us this evening. To the teachers and to the parents for contributing to this wonderful, wonderful choir. And of course, what they have done not only for us here, but around the world to audiences that are touched by these great voices, such beautiful voices, of course, deserve a beautiful setting like the one we're here tonight. I congratulate Cardinal Collins, the Archdiocese of Toronto, and all of those who have supported the restoration and its efforts of St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica. To the alumni, to the families, to the parishioners, to the Catholic community, and of course to the many men and women who performed the restoration. You should be proud of the work you've done to restore St. Michael's Cathedral to its original glory so that it may continue to stand as a reminder to everyone of the role that the Catholic Church has played here and across Ontario for hundreds of years. Your dedication to God's service plays an active role in the betterment of the lives of all Ontarians, administering the spiritual needs of his congregations, educating our children, and through music, bringing us joy. But this project was more than remembering the past. It's also about creating a bridge to the future, ensuring that St. Michael's Cathedral can continue to play its vital role, serving the needs of the neighborhood. And as the principal church of the largest English-speaking diocese in Canada, you are doing something extraordinary, not just before, but forevermore. On behalf of the Government of Ontario, please accept my congratulations to everyone involved in the restoration of St. Michael's Cathedral Basilica. We wish you many more years of providing strength, comfort, and joy to the community, and throughout the province, throughout Canada, and of course throughout the world in terms of the role that His Eminence plays and represents us all. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and congratulations.
Thank you, Minister Souza. I know you have attended a number of events with the Archdiocese of Toronto. In light of your significant responsibilities, we very much appreciate your presence here tonight. Last April, I had the privilege of visiting the Casa Vingt Frères in Saint-Hyacinthe, Quebec, and I got a sneak preview of the magnificence of Opus 3907. The next piece in this evening's program is one that showcases just how remarkable the new Casa Vingt organ is, as well as the skill of our cathedral organist, William O'Meara, Truly, it is an instrument fit for its place in this beautifully restored cathedral basilica. St. Michael's Choir School is a unique and valued partnership between the Archdiocese of Toronto and the Toronto Catholic District School Board. Bringing greetings from the board, please welcome the chair of the Toronto Catholic District, Angela Kennedy.
This feels like a little touch of heaven, doesn't it? Just want to thank you, boys. I hope you know how much everybody appreciates your musical talent. We all really, really have enjoyed this evening. And it takes someone very special, like yourselves, to be able to share that talent. That musical talent is well worth sharing, and certainly I hope every day someone tells you how much they appreciate you. So thank you so much. So I'm really humbled to be here tonight on speaking on behalf of my Toronto Catholic District School Board colleagues. Just to let you know, the Director of Education and the Associate Director of Education are here this evening, Angela Goche and Angelo San Giorgio. I know that there are superintendents, principals, teachers here this evening. I know Trustee Joanne Davis, who is the trustee for St. Michael's Choir School, is here as well. So thanks everybody for joining me. Your Eminence, Your Honor, Your Worship, clergy, honored guests, friends, the Toronto Catholic District School Board would not exist today if not for the compassion, for the dedication, and persistence of our religious leaders so many years ago. Shortly after this magnificent structure was built in 1848, the Canadian Catholic Bishop spoke on behalf of our Catholic families for separate school rights. Indeed, they were prophetic in their wise determination of the importance of the close link between Catholic parent, parish, church, and the Catholic education of our children. Since then, we've seen the results of this beautiful symmetry in the significant accomplishments of generations of young Catholic men and women. They are a living testament to our board's vision statement that challenges them to transform the world through witness, faith, innovation, and action. Coincidentally, our board is in the second year of a three-year pastoral plan. This is for us the year of the parish, which brings a renewed emphasis on harmonizing our faith through family, parish, and school. Within our classrooms, through our daily curriculum and expressions of our faith, we will strengthen this important trinity of parish, home, and school. The church and its leaders have provided our students, their families, and our staff with shelter and comfort in times of joy and sorrow. They lead us in worship, and they are role models for service to our community and to the world at large. This remarkable cathedral basilica, which has withstood the test of time as a beacon of hope, faith, and charity, is emblematic of this precious relationship. We all know that the foundation of our Catholic faith is not just built on bricks and mortar. What is more important is that this building, like our schools, is a sanctuary where the spirit of our faith is nurtured, encouraged to burn bright so that it can be shared in order to bring light and life into the community. St. Michael's Basilica Cathedral Basilica is a wonderful tribute to our extraordinary joint history. Tonight, let us celebrate our shared past and commit to strengthening our ties. On behalf of the Toronto Catholic District School Board family, I congratulate the Cardinal and the Archdiocese of Toronto on the successful restoration of this important magisterial symbol of our Catholic faith. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Kennedy. We are grateful for your presence. I now present to you the entire student body of St. Michael's Choir School in a massed choir. All 275 boys. On behalf of all those who have made this evening possible, thank you. We thank the faculty of St. Michael's Choir School, our principal Barry White, Father Bush, and of course, thank you for your leadership and continued support. I would also like to recognize the boys whose hard work this month has given beautiful music to the celebrations of the last 2 days, and their parents whose support is an invaluable part of everything we do. To our special guests and to each one of you who joined us this evening, thank you, and we hope to see you again very soon. We will end our concert tonight with our school song, A Hymn to St. Michael, Thou Royal Knight from Courts on High, composed by our founder, Monsignor John Edward Ronan, and arranged by alumnus Kola Oalabi. Thank you.